Today I am in front of you in your math class. First chapter already completed, so second chapter we start from today. In second chapter, chapter name fractions and decimals. What is fraction? Fraction is a part of whole. It is the definition. Fraction is a part of whole. Example: 1/2, 2/3, 4/6, etc. If any number be given in the form of this, it is known as fraction. Example: here 7/3 is a fraction. In this fraction, 7 is numerator and 3 is denominator. A number, a digit which is upper of the given line is known as numerator, and the digit which is below the number line is known as denominator. Type of fraction. Here we will read about the type of fraction. Three types of fraction. There are three types of fraction here in this book. First, proper fraction. Definition says that a fraction in which numerator is less than denominator. A fraction in which numerator is less than denominator is known as proper fraction. Example, 2/3. Here we see that 2 is numerator, 3 is denominator, 2 is less than 3. 4/7. Here 4 is numerator, 7 is denominator. Therefore, 4/7 is proper fraction. Similar. Next is improper fraction. Improper fraction. Definition says a fraction in which numerator is greater than denominator is called improper fraction. Example: 8/5, 9/7. Here we see. So improper fraction says that a fraction in which numerator is greater than denominator is called improper. Example: 8/5. Here 8 is numerator and 5 is denominator. Here we see that 8 is greater than 5, means numerator is greater than denominator. These fractions are known as improper fraction. Next, mixed fraction. Now, third fraction, mixed fraction. Definition says that a fraction which is combination of whole numbers. And a proper fraction is called mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is combination of whole number and a proper fraction. Example: 2/1/5, it is a mixed fraction. 3/4/7, it is a mixed fraction. Here we see that 2 is whole number and 1/5 proper fraction. Therefore, 2/1/5 is mixed fraction. Similarly, 3/4/7, 3 is whole number, 4/7 is proper fraction. Therefore, 3/4/7 is mixed fraction. That's now we are going to start your chapter 2.1. Okay, now I'm going to solve your exercise 2.1. Question first, ask solve. First, 2 − 3/5. It is subtraction of fraction. Here 2, we can write a by 1. Now 2/1
minus 3 by 5. For it, we already know that we take LCM of 1 and 5. LCM of 1 and 5 is equal to 1 into 5. Therefore, 5. We divide in 5 by 1, 5, 5 to the 3. Minus 5 on the 5, 1 to the 3. Is equal to 7 by 5 answer. Similarly, you can solve the next question. 6. 6 number question is question number first. 2 upon 2 by 3 plus 3 upon 1 by 2. It is the mixed fraction. We convert it in improper fraction. Then we add both. For it, 3 to the 6 plus 2, 8 by 3 plus 2, 3 to 6, 1, 7, 7 by 2. LCM of 3 and 2, we take LCM of 3 and 2 is equal to 6. We divide 6 by 3, 3 to the 6, 2, we multiply 2 with 8, 2, 8, that's 16 plus. Again, we divide 6 by 2. 2, 3, 6, 3, 3, 7, 21 is equal to 6, 1, 7, 1, 2, 3 by 6 is equal to 6 upon 1 by 60. Answer. Now, question number 2. Question number 2 says, arrange the following in descending order. In this question, two questions we given. I'm going to solve your first question and second question you will done by yourself. 2 by 9, 2 by 3, 8 by 1. Question asked, arrange it in a descending order. For it, we change all these given numbers as the same denominator. For it, we find the LCM of 9, 3, 21. LCM of 9, 3, 21 is equal to 63. 2 by 9 is equal to 2 by 9 into. We divide given LCM 63 by 9. 9, 7, 63. We multiply 7 by 7 in this fraction. 14 by 63. Then 2 by 3. 2 by 3 in. We divide again LCM 63 by 3 in 20 times. And we multiply 21 by 21 is equal to 42 by 63. Now 8 by 21 is equal to 8 by 21 into. We divide given LCM 63 by 21. It comes 3 times. Then 3 by 3. 8 3 by 24 by 63. Now we compare 14 by 63, 42 by 63, 24 by 63. Here we see that all denominators are same. So, the numerator which is greater is a largest. So, here we see that 42 is greater than 24 and 14. Therefore, it is the largest number. It is the largest number. So, we can write as in descending order. 42 by 63. Then we will write it 24 by 63. Then 14 by 63. And we know that 42 by 63 has come for the place of 2 by 3. Therefore, 2 by 3, comma, 24 by 63 means 8 by 21. 14 by 63. 14 by 63 means 2 by 9. It is not answer. Question 4
kata hai.
Question 4 says that a length of rectangular sheet is equal to 12 upon 1 by 2 cm. Width of rectangular sheet 10 upon 2 by 3 cm. Find the perimeter of given sheet. It is a rectangular sheet. We know that perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into a plus b.
Therefore, perimeter of rectangular sheet is equal to 2 into a plus b is equal to 2. A means 12 upon 1 by 2 plus b means 10 upon 2 by 3. It is in mixed fraction, so first we change it in improper fraction. 24, 125. 25 by 2 plus 30, 32, 32 by 3. LCM of 2, 3 is equal to 6. 6 divided by 2, 3 times 25 plus 3 divided 6, 2 times 2, 6, 32, 64 is equal to 2 into, we add both 5, 4, 9. 7, 6, 139 by 6, 2, 3, 139 by 3 means you will divide it 3, 4, 12, 1, 3, 6, 18 upon 1 by 3 cm. Answer. Now, in question 5, question 5 also asked the perimeter. In question 5, a figure be given in your book, and in figure, a rectangle and a triangle be given. Question be asked, which perimeter is greater, triangle or rectangle? You will find each time perimeter of triangle and perimeter of rectangle, then you compare. Okay, if you have any problem, you will contact your mobile number, and now we start a new chapter. Self question you will done self.